Welcome today to this Yoga for All class. My name is Barri. Let's go ahead and get started by finding a comfortable seated position on your mat. We'll just begin with a few moments of mindfulness. So you can rest your hands down on your knees or in your lap. And close your eyes. Or perhaps just slightly close them, keeping a little bit of space for light to enter between your eyelids. Make sure that your back is straight, but not tense. Just settling ourselves in to the sacred space of our mats today. We do our best to let go of any other thoughts or distractions, anything else happening in the world besides what's happening right now on our mats. We can let that all go. Everything else can wait. This is our time to practice, our time to connect our bodies, our minds, and our breaths, so we can find what is real and true within us. So take a few moments here. Bring your awareness to your breath. Noticing every inhale. And every exhale. Well, you don't need to force it or change the breath in any way. Just simply observe. Every breath in, and every breath out. Quieting our minds, practicing single-pointed focus. Following every inhale. And following every exhale out. And after practicing in this way for a little while, you can start to notice a feeling of peace arising from within the space of our hearts. This is our truth. This is our true nature. So throughout this practice, our goal is to keep our awareness on this state, on this place of peace. Holding on to this feeling, take your hands together at the center of your heart. And set an intention for your practice today. Whatever that may be, whatever brings you on the mat today. We'll do our best to hold on to this intention and this feeling of peace throughout the rest of our practice and the rest of our day. Let's take a full deep breath in through your nose. And as you exhale, gently blink your eyes open. Lower your hands down to your sides. Good. Inhale, reach your arms up overhead. Interlace your fingers and push your palms through the ceiling. Just get a nice stretch through your ribs. Open your heart, maybe a little bend back. And exhale, release your hands down in front of you. Come onto all fours, tabletop position. Good. So we'll start with some cat-cows. Inhale, arch your back, look up towards the ceiling. Exhale, tuck your tailbone under, round your spine, and gaze towards your navel. Good. Inhaling to arch and look up. And exhaling to round. So you can take these cat-cows now at your own pace. Matching your breath with the movements of your body. Fullest, deepest breaths in. And fullest, deepest breaths out. And one more. Just notice how you feel today. Move in the way that works best for you in this moment. On your next inhale, come back through center, and as you exhale, start to bend side to side. Little wag of your tail. Looking back over your shoulders, towards your toes. Stretching out through the side body. Take one more. We'll start to take circles through our hips and our whole spine, back, neck, shoulders, whole body circles. So we'll do a lot of hip openers in today's class. Starting right now to just warm up through our hips, but you can let the rest of the body get involved too, and close your eyes. And take one more on this side. And go the other way. Don't worry about what it looks like. Just move any way that feels good to you. And take one more here. Good. Coming back to your neutral tabletop position, bring your big toes to touch. Widen your knees to the outer edges of your mat. And as you exhale, walk your hands out in front of you, lower your chest to the floor. Keep your hips elevated and feel a stretch across your shoulders. Spread your fingers, keep your arms active. And just breathe, reconnect with your intention. Feel your heart melting into the earth. And take one more full breath here in through your nose. And out through your nose. And on your next inhale, press yourself back up to all fours. Turn your knees under your hips. Tuck your toes under. Start to float your knees. Pull your belly in. And as you exhale, press back to your first downward dog of the day. So first downward dog can be nice and easy. Pedal out your feet. Bending one knee and then the other. And shake your head, yes and no. Just let it be gentle. Keeping your mind's eye on your breath. Maybe you want to take it to a little twist. Again, just stretching out the hips a little bit more. Little twist side to side. And just take one more on each side. And come back to your downward dog, reaching for stillness, rolling your shoulders back. Just breathe here. On your next inhale, reach your right leg up to a three-legged dog. Bend your knee and stack the right hip on top of the left. Doesn't matter how high your leg is, just do whatever you can today. Start to circle out through that right hip. Just notice how it feels. And circle the other way. And on your next inhale, reach it back up to your three-legged dog. Square your hips towards the floor. And step your right foot in between your hands. Keep the back heel lifted and the knee lifted. We'll rise up to a high lunge. Find your balance. Squeeze your inner thighs towards each other. Find your pelvic floor. Right, last week we worked a lot on grounding. So if you were here, try to remember that feeling here. Feeling your feet connecting to the earth, feeling your pelvic floor, feeling your low belly. And take one more inhale. And exhale, lower your hands down and lower your back knee down. We'll come to a low lunge. Untuck your toes, shift your hips forward. Good. Surrendering down to gravity, trying not to hold on so tight. So just observe where you're holding tension in your body. Perhaps the weather is a little bit cooler, so we often tense up when it's colder out, so just notice. See if you can release a little bit. Using your breath to help you go deeper without pushing, right? So we take our time to open up. Never want to just push or force any positions. From here, start to roll onto your right pinky toe, send your right knee away. And you can look to the right, take it to a twist. Feeling that external rotation of the right hip joint. You can stay here or bend the left knee and reach around to catch the left foot in your right hand. Starting to feel the top of your left hip, your hip flexor getting involved. We'll take one more inhale. Exhale, release your back foot. Take both hands to the inside of your right foot. Tuck your back toes under and heel toe the right foot to the outer edge of your mat. We come to a lizard lunge. So you can stay on your hands. If you'd like to, you can keep the back knee lifted or keep it down on the mat. And you can untuck your toes. And either stay on your hands or lower down to your forearms. Yeah. And again, just observe, right? You can take your time, maybe stay a few breaths on your hands and then lower down so the hips are a place where we can hold a lot of emotions. We have a lot going on in our life. Our hips might tighten up. We might feel a lot of emotions release as we start to go deeper into our hips today. We might feel anger or frustration, any other emotions you're holding on to today might arise. So our job is to try not to let those emotions control us. We can notice when they arise and work through them to come back to that place of peace that we found at the beginning of our practice. Stay for just a few more breaths here. Slow down the breaths. And on your next inhale, start to press back up to your hands, heel toe the right foot back to the center of your chest. And then as you exhale, send your hips back and flex the right foot. Come to your half split. Good. Deep breaths. And to back off, walk your hands further back towards you, or you can take your hands to blocks. To go deeper, keep your hands out further away and maybe take hold of the ball of your foot, reaching your toes back towards you. Good. Everyone looks great. Keep reaching the right hip back in its socket. One more breath here. And exhale back to your low lunge. Inhale, tuck your back toes, float your knee. And exhale, step back to your downward dog. Just take a moment and notice the difference between both hips. See if you feel differently on one side than the other. And on your next inhale, reach the left leg up to your three-legged dog. Bend your knee and stack the left hip on top of the right. Remember, it doesn't matter how high it is. Start to circle it out. It's starting to release in the left hip. And you can circle the other way. And inhale, reach it back up to your three-legged dog, square your hips towards the floor. Exhale, step your foot in between your hands, keep the back heel and knee lifted. Find your inner thighs connection, find your pelvic floor and your low belly. And rise up to your high lunge, reach your arms up towards the ceiling, maybe look up, find your balance. Feel that opposition of the grounding down at the same time as you're lifting up. Staying evenly between the ground and the sky. And take one more inhale here. Exhale with control, lower your hands down. And lower your right knee down. And untuck your toes. And release your hips towards the floor. Deep breaths here. Relaxing into the hips. Let's give them space and time to open. Just notice if you're holding on really tightly here. If you're clenching, anywhere in your body, maybe even the muscles of your face. Let's see if you can soften everywhere. Send more breath. And stay for one more breath. See if you can soften a little bit more in your hips. And roll onto the left pinky toe. Start to open out through your left hip, sending your knee out to the side, just gently pressing it away. Taking it a little twist to the left. And then maybe you can bend the right knee and reach around and take hold of the right foot with your left hand. Right? Just maybe. Just see what happens. One more inhale here. Looking beautiful. Exhale, come back around to center. Take both hands to the inside of your left foot. Heel toe the left foot out to the outer edge of your mat. We find a lizard. So you can keep the back toes tucked. You can float the back knee up if that feels better for you. Or you can lower everything down, untuck your toes. You can stay on your hands for a few breaths or as long as you need to. And if it feels available for you, you can come down to your forearms. You might notice that this side feels different from the right side. Maybe not. For some people, it can be quite different. So just observe, honor your body. No judgment, no expectations. Take care of your body and your mind. That's all we're here to do. If you can find a little bit more space, softening down. One more breath here. On your next inhale, start to walk your hands back up. Heel toe your left foot back to your center line. Walk your hands to the outside of your foot. And send your hips back. Flex your left foot, finding your half split. Starting to feel your hamstrings. And again, to back off of this, come up higher, walk your hands further back towards you, maybe to blocks. And to go deeper, walk further out towards your foot, maybe even further out than your foot. The more you can take hold of the ball of your foot and reach your toes back towards your nose. Wherever you are, remember to breathe. One more full deep breath here. And exhale, come back to your low lunge. Inhale, tuck your back toes, lift your back knee, and exhale, step back to your downward dog. Inhale, rise to your toes, look forward, walk your feet all the way up to your hands. Keep them separated, hips distance apart. Inhale, lengthen halfway up. And exhale, fold all the way down. You can keep a soft bend in your knees. Rest your chest down on your thighs. And just let all of your energy flow out the top of your head. And you can shake your head yes and no. You can gently sway side to side, maybe catch opposite elbows. Deep breaths. On your next inhale, release your hands. Lengthen your spine, lift halfway up. Heel toe your feet back together. And exhale, fold all the way down. Take a soft bend behind your knees and slowly roll all the way up, vertebrae by vertebrae, bringing your head up last. And roll your shoulders down your back, feel your feet in the floor. Take your hands to prayer for a moment. You can close your eyes. Feeling your engagement in your body, your feet, your legs, your pelvic floor, and low belly. And find that place of peace again within your heart. Reconnect with the intention that you created at the beginning of our practice. And take one more, a full deep breath here. And as you exhale, gently blink your eyes open. And begin our sun salutations. Inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, fold all the way down, hands to outside of your feet. Inhale, lengthen, lift halfway up. Exhale, step back, high plank. Inhale here. Exhale, chaturanga, or your version. You can lower all the way down. Inhale, lift up to a cobra or upward dog, lifting your knees, engaging your thighs. Exhale, roll back over your toes, downward dog. Feet are separated, hips width apart. Relax your shoulders away from your ears. Come back to your breath. One more breath here. Inhale, rise to your toes, look forward. Step or jump your feet to your hands, lift halfway. Exhale, fold all the way down. Inhale, rise all the way up, press your palms, look up. And exhale, fold straight back down, hands to the floor. Inhale, lengthen, lift halfway up. Exhale, step or jump back to your chaturanga or modified chaturanga. Inhale, roll forward to up dog or cobra. Exhale, roll back down or dog. Just building heat in our bodies. When we come back to our downward dog, we come back to that place of stillness, that place of peace. One more breath here. Inhale, rise to your toes, look forward, step or jump your feet to your hands, lift halfway. Exhale, fold down. Inhale, rise up. And exhale, last time, fold straight back down, hands to the floor. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, step or jump back, chaturanga, or your version. Good. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward dog. Hold it here. See if you can take more weight out of your arms. Shift your weight back towards your heels. Reaching your heels closer to the floor. One more breath. Inhale, rise to your toes, look forward, step or jump your feet between your hands, lift halfway. Exhale, fold down. Inhale, rise all the way up. And exhale, Tadasana, mountain pose, arms down by your sides. take our Surya Namaskar B. Inhale, Utkatasana, chair pose. Bend your knees, sink your hips towards your heels. Press your palms, look up. Exhale, fold all the way down, hands to the floor. Inhale, lengthen, lift halfway. Exhale, step or jump back, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Now inhale, step your right foot in between your hands, spin the back heel down. Rise up to warrior one, keep a deep bend, 90 degrees in the right knee. Really reach up, look up. And exhale, open out warrior two. Spread your arms wide. Maybe sink a little bit lower. Gazing over your right fingertips. Inhale, turn your right palm to face the ceiling. Reach back to reverse your warrior. Big stretch across the whole right side. Good. Exhale, extended side angle, left right forearm to right thigh, left arm sweeps over your ear. Maybe lower the right hand down to the outside of your right foot. Maybe bend the right knee a little bit more, should be right over your right ankle. Inhale, engage through your pelvic floor and rise all the way up to straight legs. Turn all 10 toes to the left side of your mat. Legs out wide, exhale, hands to your waist. Inhale here, roll your shoulders back, create space in your chest, open your heart. And exhale, fold down, hands to the floor in between your feet. Good, inhale, lengthen, just lift halfway up. Exhale, fold all the way down. Bring the top of your head down to the floor. Maybe walk your hands further back. If your head's not touching the floor, just stay wherever you are. Breathe. Maybe you can take your head to a block. Inhale, we lift halfway up. Start to walk your hands over to the right and just bend the right knee for Skandasana. It's like a deep side low lunge. Take your hands to prayer and point the left toes. Ah, so we feel the hips again here. Keep your chest open. A deep breath. Reach the right hand down in front of you and reach the left arm up. Look up to your left hand. Exhale, release your hand back down. Walk your hands around the right foot again, coming to a low lunge. Lower your left knee down and sit back. So we're going to come to like a half hero's pose or Tiryangamukha. Ikapada Paschimottanasana. So take your knees together, send your left heel out to the side. If you need to, you can stay sitting on the left heel. Otherwise, try to take it out to the side and we'll exhale and fold over the right leg, catch your right foot. Yeah, good. If you have a strap, you can use a strap if it's hard to reach your foot, or just take your hands down to wherever you can reach on your right leg. So good. If you're there, just exhale, fold forward. See if you can reach your chin towards your shin or your forehead towards your leg. Stay for one more breath in. Full exhale, release a little bit more. Inhale, come back through your low lunge. Walk your hands back through center. And we're going to come over to the other side. So walk your hands over to the left, coming to your Skandasana on the left. Point your right toes. Take your hands to prayer. Good. See if you can roll your shoulders back, lift your chest, open your heart. Good. Lower the left hand down, reach the right arm up, feel your side body opening up. Beautiful. Exhale, lower the right hand down and walk your hands over to your left foot. Find your low lunge. Lower the right knee down, untuck your toes. Shift your hips back all the way. Either hip stays on your heel or see if you can take your hips out to the left so that the right heel comes to the outside of the right hip. You can also sit on a block. Right, that's all you And once you're there, exhale, fold forward, catch your left foot, or just take your hands wherever they can reach on your left leg. Or you can hold a strap. Try to keep the right sit bone reaching down towards the floor. Again, you can sit on the heel if it's hard to do it with the heel out to the side. Try to keep your knees together. Unless you have pain in your knee, it can be further out. Keep sending energy out through the left foot. One more breath, create a little bit more space. Inhale, come back to your low lunge. And back to your skandhasana on the left. Take your hands back to the of your legs, bring your toes together, straighten your knees back to your wide-legged forward fold. Prasarita Padottanasana. Let's inhale, lengthen, lift halfway up. And exhale, fold all the way back down. If you have a headstand in your practice and you want to take that now, you are welcome to. Sometimes it can be fun and feel good to go upside down. But you are under no obligation to try. Just if you would like to do that here, you can. Otherwise, just stay. And just see if you can shift your weight more forward. Maybe the heels can start to float up. Deep breaths. And if you're in a headstand, slowly start to lower back down. And inhale, let's lengthen, lift halfway up. Exhale there. Inhale, hands to your waist, rise all the way back up to standing and turn your left toes to face the back of your mat. Stretch your arms out, exhale to warrior two. Sink low. Looking over your left fingertips. Inhale, flip your left palm up towards the ceiling. Reach back, reverse your warrior. Exhale, extended side angle. Left forearm to left thigh. Right arm sweeps over your ear. Or lower the left hand down to the outside of your left foot. Your right shoulder back, look up to your right hand. Deep breaths. And on your next inhale, rise all the way back up to your warrior two. And inhale, switch your hips to face towards your left leg. Warrior one. Press your palms together. Look up. Exhale, lower your hands down. Step back to your vinyasa. Take your chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. Good. Deep, full breaths. Inhale, rise to your toes, look forward, step or jump your feet to the top of your mat, lift halfway. Exhale, fold all the way down. Inhale, bend your knees, sink your hips towards your heels, and come back to your chair pose, Utkatasana. You're facing the back of your mat. Press your palms together, look up. Exhale, hands to prayer. Roll your shoulders back, open your chest. Exhale, twist to the right, hook your left elbow around the outside of your right knee. Open your chest. Good. Shift all of your weight to your right leg. Step the left leg back to a revolved extended side angle. You can stay here or split your arms. And on your next inhale, we rise all the way back up. Keep your right toes facing the back of your mat. Heel toe the left foot in one time. And exhale, Trikonasana, triangle pose. Right hand reaches down somewhere along the right leg. Left arm reaches straight up. Take your shoulders back over your hips. Really reach up long through the left arm. And as you exhale, take a pyramid pose. Take both hands to the outside of your right foot. Maybe step the left foot back in one more time. Fold straight over your right leg. Square your hips and shoulders. Deep breaths. Inhale, lift halfway up. Take your left hand to the outside of your right foot. Reach the right arm up for a revolve triangle. Really open your chest to the right. Beautiful. Exhale, lower your hands back down to either side of the right foot. Inhale, step back to a lunge with the left leg. And we'll step back to a downward dog. Inhale, rise to your toes. Look forward, step or jump your feet to your hands. Lift halfway up. Exhale, fold down. Inhale, Utkatasana, bend your knees, sink your hips to your heels, press your palms together, look up, keep your hips low. Exhale, hands to prayer. Inhale, shoulders back, chest opens. Exhale, twist to the left, hook your right elbow to the outside of your left knee. Shift your weight to your left leg, step the right leg back. Maybe split your hands, look up to the left hand. And inhale, find your pelvic floor, rise all the way up. Straight legs, left toes reach towards the back. And exhale, lower the left hand down, find your Trikonasana, triangle pose. Right arm reaches straight up, so hips and shoulders are in one line. Look up to the right hand, deep breaths. Belly in, pelvic floor engaged. One more inhale, reaching up. Exhale, fold over your left leg. Step the right foot in just a little bit for pyramid pose. Square your hips and shoulders. As you exhale, really fold down. Just breathe. Inhale, lengthen, lift halfway up. Walk your right hand around the outside of your left foot, maybe just your fingertips. Reach the left arm up. Revolve triangle. Open through your chest. Exhale, take both hands back down around the outside of your left foot. Step the right leg back a little bit longer. And then exhale, step back to your downward dog. Inhale, reach the right leg up to your three-legged dog. Exhale, find a pigeon pose. Take the right foot behind your left wrist. Good. Open your chest. And exhale, walk your hands down in front of the right leg. You can lower down to your forearms. Saying hello to your hips again. can stay on your forearms if that's enough. If you can go deeper, you can take your hands one on top of the other and lower your forehead down like a pillow. Or extend your arms all the way out in front of you. Just breathe. Reconnect to your breath. Slow it down. And on your next inhale, start to walk back up. Shift your weight off a little bit to the right and swing your left leg around. Find a double pigeon, so stack the left leg on top of the right. And then lower your hands down in front of your legs. Notice how you feel. Observe the emotions that arise. Observe the physical sensations that arise. And slowly start to walk your hands back up. And step the left foot all the way around the right thigh and pull the right heel closer into you. You're going to hug the left leg in with your right elbow, sit up tall. And exhale, twist to the left. So you can keep just hugging it in with the hook of your elbow. Or you can take your right elbow to the outside of your left knee to take a little bit of a deeper twist. One more breath here. Good, let's exhale, take a counter twist. So take both hands around to the right, little bend down to the right. And we're going to turn to the other side. So keep walking your hands around until you come to a lunge facing the front of your mat. Good. And exhale, step back to your downward dog. One breath. Inhale, reach the left leg up to your three-legged dog. Exhale, find your pigeon on the left. Take your left toes behind your right wrist. Extend the right leg long back behind you. You can start to walk your hands back, just open through your heart. And when you feel ready, exhale, fold down. And observing the difference between both sides, keeping our mind equanimous, non-judgmental. If it's available for you to come down lower, you can stack your hands, lower your forehead down, or even extend your arms just straight out in front of you. See if you can come back to that place of peace in the space of your heart. And if you can send more breath into your hips and allow yourself to release more, let go of any tension, let go of any sense of needing to hold on. And stay for one more breath. On your next inhale, start to walk your hands back up. Shift your hips off to the left and swing the right leg around. Find your double pigeon, stacking the right leg on top of the left. And walk your hands down over your legs again. Now we'll feel the right hip again. Your legs are in like a box shape. The right foot is just over the left knee. Right knee is over the left foot. And you know, you don't even need to fold over here. It might just be enough to try to just sit like that with your legs stacked. Yeah? And so just do what's best for you. One more deep breath here. And on your next inhale, press yourself back up slowly with control. Take the right foot to the outside of the left thigh. Pull the left heel in closer to you. Hug the right knee in with your left elbow. Sit up tall, take the right hand back. And as you exhale, twist to the right. You can stay here or go deeper with a twist by holding the left elbow to the outside of your right knee. And a nice deep twist, cleansing your internal organs. One more inhale here. Exhale, counter twist. Take both hands down to the left. We'll bend down and start to walk your hands all the way back around to the back of your mat. And we'll exhale, step back to your downward dog here. From here, just lower your knees, untuck your toes, sit your hips back on your heels, child's pose. Extend your arms. Slow down your breathing. Coming back to your intentions. Back to your breath. Inhale, slowly roll all the way up vertebrae by vertebrae. Bringing your head up last. Good, and let's sit off to one side. Swing your legs around in front of you. And we have to, as always, do a little bit of core work. So we'll take our Navasana position. Hug your thighs into your chest. Rise up to your toes. Lift your feet up and extend your arms. Good, maybe straight legs. Belly button to your spine. Lift your chest to your legs. Lift your legs to your chest. Hold for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now 5 counts to lower all the way down to your back. Go 1, nice and slow. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Exhale, slowly lower all the way down. Walk your feet in towards your hips. Find a bridge pose. So walk your fingertips to graze your heels. And inhale, slowly lift your hips up off the floor. Keeping your feet separated, hips width apart, squeeze your inner thighs towards each other. Feel that activation of your legs. You can stay here, come up higher by interlacing your fingers, tucking your shoulder blades under more, or you can take a full wheel pose. Fingertips towards your shoulders, come up to your head, and then press away. Wherever you are, stay for one more breath. Feel the activation of your legs, inner thighs. And exhale, slowly lower all the way down, vertebrae by vertebrae. Good. Hug your knees into your chest. And rock gently side to side. You can separate your knees, hold on to the outer edges of your feet. Just keep rocking, happy baby. Reaching your sacrum down to the floor. Releasing any stuck tension that might still be there in your hips. Maybe straightening one leg and then the other. Exhale, take the soles of your feet together, down on the floor, open your knees out to the side for a reclined butterfly pose. You can close your eyes, rest your hands either on your thighs or maybe one hand on your belly and one hand on your heart. Feeling your breath moving between these two places. Check in with your heart space. Notice how it feels. Call to mind something you're grateful for today. And you can release your hands down by your sides with your palms facing up. And you can keep your feet together or extend your legs out straight for our final few moments of relaxation. Let everything go. Release all control. Keeping your mind present. Focus on how your body feels, any subtle sensations that have arisen underneath your skin. You can stay here as long as you like. When you feel ready, you can gently begin to reawaken your body, wiggling your fingers and your toes, circling your wrists and your ankles, Reaching your arms back overhead, long reach from your fingers to your toes. And keeping your eyes closed, just take a fetal position on one side. And gently press yourself back up to a comfortable seated position. Take your hands to prayer at the center of your heart. Feel your heart beat on your thumbs. Notice any amount of peace that has arisen throughout your practice, any sense of calm, or any other feelings that have arisen. Come back to your intention from the beginning of your practice and honor that intention. And thank yourself for showing up and practicing today. I hope that you'll hold on to these seeds of peace that we planted here today for the rest of your day and every day. Namaste.